precharine nirvishesha shunyavadi paschatya deshatarine jai shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda shri advaita gadadhar shri vasade gaur bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the activities of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as described in the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
我们在讲述的是《Chaitanya Charitamrita》永恒的《Chaitanya经》《Madhya Lila》这一部分关于Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的逍遥活动。And
this chapter is chapter 11. It's entitled the Beda Kirtan Pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那我们现在讲述的呢是第十一章，讲述的是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的Beda Kirtan 活动。
Right. So we're told how Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, remember, is in charge of he oversees the activities in the temple of Lord Jagannath, and Lord Chaitanya made him a devotee.
那我们讲述到了Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya，那Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya呢，他在负责的是Jagannath庙里面的所有的这些事项，然后呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，把他给转变成了一位奉献者。So
it happened one day that Sarvabhauma came to see Lord Chaitanya, and he said he wanted to ask him something.
那有一天呢？
And he said, I want to ask you this without fear. So Lord Chaitanya told him that, all right, you can speak without fear, but if the statement is not suitable, then I will reject it. It doesn't mean I'm going to accept whatever you say.
Okay, 是Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya对Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，我想在没有恐惧的心态下向您询问一些事情。然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就说呢，好吧，你问吧。但是如果你要是问我的这个话题要是不恰当的话呢，那我可能就不会接受，我可能就会拒绝你所说的这些话。
Yes. So the Bhattacharya said, there's a king, the king of Jagannath Puri. His name is Prataparudra Raya. Yeah, he's very anxious to meet Lord Chaitanya, and he wants to get permission from Lord Chaitanya to meet him.
那他呢就非常急切地想要见到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，所以呢他就希望能够得到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的许可，能够拜见主。But
as soon as Lord Chaitanya heard this, Lord Chaitanya covered his ears and he said, "Why are you asking such an undesirable thing from me?"
然后呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu一听他这么一说呢，立刻就把自己的耳朵给堵上了，就问他。
Lord Chaitanya said, I'm in the renounced order, and it's dangerous for me to meet a king, just as dangerous as it is for me to meet a woman.
对于我来说，见一位国王所处在的这种危险性，就和见一位女人所处于的危险是一样的。It would
be just like drinking poison for me to do this.
让我去见这位国王，就好像是喝毒药一样。So
Lord Chaitanya was very sad that this Bhattacharya had made this request. And he told him, he said, you know, I'm trying to cross the ocean of material existence.
所以对于 Bhattacharya 向 Sri Krishna, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 提出这样的请求，使得 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就感到非常的伤心。他说，你看，我在努力的要跨过这物质的存在之洋。
And to see a materialistic person engaged in sense gratification, or to see a woman who's of a similar nature, then it's worse than drinking poison.
去见一个从事物质感官享乐活动的物质主义者，以及去见一个有着相同本性的女人，对我来说比喝毒药还要痛苦，还要糟糕。
Ordinary people, they don't know anything about spiritual life, or they don't know about the spiritual world.
作为一个普通的人，他对于灵性生活或对于灵性世界是一无所知的。
Of course, in the Bhagavad Gita, there are two places in the Bhagavad Gita where the spiritual world is mentioned.
在圣典不加梵歌里呢，有两个地方就提到了灵性世界。
So in the eighth chapter, it says that there's another nature, an unmanifested nature.
然后在圣典不加梵歌的第八章里面呢，就提到了有另外一个本性，就有另外一个没有被展示的本性。
And it is never annihilated. When the whole material world is annihilated, it remains as it is.
那个地方呢是永远都不会被销毁的。当整个的宇宙被销毁的时候，那个地方依然会存在。
So this is proof. This is Lord Krishna's statement that there's a spiritual world.
那所以这个呢，就是主通过他的表述来证实了是有一个灵性世界的。
So spiritual advancement means to stop material activities.
灵性的进步也就意味着是要停止物质的活动。
And to stop material activities, you have to take up spiritual activities, like in Bhakti Yoga.
但是如果你要是想停止物质活动的话呢，就必须要去从事灵性的活动，比如说从事 Bhakti Yoga, 风爱瑜伽。
So in the material world, the main type of sense gratification is there in dealing with the opposite sex.
那么在物质世界呢，最主要的感官享乐的活动就是和异性的交往。
So when we become serious about spiritual life, we have to be very careful in dealing with the opposite sex.
所以说，当我们非常认真的要进行我们灵性的休息的时候，我们就要非常的小心的去应对和异性的交往。
And we should never see the other sex for material benefit.
而且呢，我们也不能够因为要获得物质的益处去和异性交往。
And if you just talk to them about materialistic things, then it's worse than drinking poison.
如果我们只是为了要去和他们探讨一些物质相关的事情的话，那其实就是比喝毒药还要糟糕的事情了。
So Lord Chaitanya was very strict on that point.
所以说呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu对这一点是非常严格的。
So that's why he didn't want to meet the king.
也就是这个原因，他不想见国王。
Because the king's always engaged in politics and economic things and sense gratification.
因为国王呢，他总是处于在这个政治啊、经济啊，还有感官享乐的活动中。
So even though the request was coming from someone like Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, still Lord Chaitanya was not willing to meet the king.
所以说呢。即便是有像 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 这样的伟大的人物的请求， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 依然不想见这位国王。
So Sarvabhauma told Lord Chaitanya, he said, yes, he said, I know everything you're saying is true. He said, but this king is not an ordinary king.
然后 Sarvabhauma 就对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢， 我知道您说的每一句话都是对的，都是的确是这样事实。但是呢，这位国王他可不是一位普通的国王。
He's a great devotee and he's a servant of Lord Jagannath.
他是一位伟大的奉献者，他是主加格纳德的仆人。
And Lord Chaitanya says, "Well, yeah, I know he's a good devotee, but still, we should consider him to be like a snake, a poison snake."
是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，我知道他是一位好的奉献者，但是我们依然要把他当成是一条有毒的蛇。
And then Lord Chaitanya said, "He said, just like a woman may be made of wood, then maybe the model." Which is of the form of a woman in wood, but that form, although it's made of wood, it can agitate the mind of a man if he touches that form. If he touches that form of the woman, even though it's made of wood, it can agitate his mind.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，就好像是由木雕刻的一个女子的形象。那么如果要是一个男人，他去触碰了这个由木头所雕刻的女子的形象的话。也会让他的内心发生翻搅。
So the idea is we should learn to avoid, we should learn to give up the association of materialistic people and associate with people who are spiritually advanced.
那所以这里面要讲述的概念呢，就是我们应该学着去放弃和物质主义者的交往，然后呢，要学会和有灵性修为的人交往。
Just like a snake is dangerous and poisonous.
那么就好像是一条蛇，它是非常危险的，是有毒的。
Even though it may be decorated with jewels, it doesn't mean it's less poisonous or less dangerous.
即便是这条蛇，它装点着珠宝，但并不意味着它就不危险，它就没有毒了。
So somebody may be a very qualified materialist.But he's no better than a snake who's got jewels.
那么所以说，一个人他也许可能是一位非常有资格的物质主义者，他有很多的这个资质，但是并不意味着他就不是一条蛇，他只不过是被装点起来的蛇而已。
So when you deal with a poison snake, even if it has a jewel on its head, you have to be very careful. And the same way, when you deal with materialistic people, you have to be very careful.
所以说呢，就是当你在和一条蛇在打交道的时候，即便是这条蛇它脑袋上戴着皇冠，但是你也要非常的小心，因为它是有毒的。所以说呢，当我们在和物质主义者在打交道的时候，我们要非常的小心。
Just like people can be sexually agitated just by touching the wooden form of a woman.
那么就好像是当一个人他触碰了这个由木头雕制的这个女子的身形的时候。
Our mind is so restless that any moment we can be conquered by material desires. The six enemies are there. The six enemies are lust, anger, and greed.
Sorry, Mark. 我们有六个敌人，这六个敌人呢是色欲、愤怒，还有贪婪。
And then illusion, madness, and envy.
然后呢就是虚幻、疯狂和嫉妒。
So we have to be very careful in dealing with the mind. We have to train our mind that we have to train the mind that he.Cannot do just what he likes.
所以呢，我们要非常小心的去对待我们的心意。我们要好好的训练我们的心意，不能够让心意恣意妄为的去做自己想做的事情。
We should always keep our mind engaged in the service of Lord Krishna.
所以呢，我们总是要让我们的心意去从事对师父 Krishna 的服务的活动中。
Then the enemies, these six enemies, they'll be conquered.
这样的话呢，这六个敌人就能够被征服了。
But if our mind is not in thinking in Krishna consciousness, then at any moment we can be conquered by the material desires.
但是如果我们的内心没有想着对 Sri Krishna 的服务的话，那么任何一个时刻，我们的内心
So chanting Hare Krishna is very important for us to keep our mind absorbed.
所以说呢, 念诵 Hare Krishna 的圣名对我们来说是一个非常重要的活动, 这样就可以让我们的心意始终处于专注沉浸的状态。
So we should follow the example of Lord Chaitanya. We should not indulge in any of these situations where the mind may become uncontrolled.
所以说呢，我们就应该追随Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的步伐，然后呢，不要去从事任何一个有可能让我们的心意处于那种沉醉状态上的活动。Even
somebody may be spiritually advanced, but if you allow the mind to think about sense gratification, then you can quickly be degraded.
Sorry, Maharaj, there was, in the beginning...
Right, there's instability, yeah. Okay, so
yeah.
I was saying that even though one may be spiritually advanced, at any time, the mind, if it's not properly controlled, it can degrade a person.
Okay, 就是即便是一个人他在灵性上处于很进步的状态, 但如果他的心意处在一个不稳定的一个状态的话，那么他有可能会堕落的。So
association with materialistic people can cause this problem to the mind.
但是呢，和物质主义者相联谊，就有可能会为我们的心意产生这些麻烦、这些问题。And
Lord Chaitanya said, just like if you see a live snake, you become afraid of it.
所以陈丹娘妈妈说，就好像你看见一条活的蛇，这会儿你就会感到对它害怕。So
a person who is trying for self-realization, they should have the same fear of materialistic people.
所以呢，当一个想要达到自我觉悟的人，他就应该对物质主义者感到害怕。And
he shouldn't even look at their bodily features.
而且呢，他也不应该去看他们的身体的身姿。
And so Lord Chaitanya told the Bhattacharya, he said, if you keep speaking like this, you will never see me here again.
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Bhattacharya, if you keep speaking like this, you will never see me here
again. So don't ask a request like this again. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya became afraid and he went home. And he began to think what to do.
So in the Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he became a little bit afraid. So he went home and thought, "What should I do?"
So at that time, the king's residence was at another place. It was not in Jagannath Puri. So he came to Jagannath Puri. The king arrived in Jagannath Puri along with his secretaries and is all his entourage, and they went to see the temple of Lord Jagannath.
这位国王呢，他的宅邸并不在Jagannath Puri，在另外一个地方。所以现在呢，他就带着他的秘书啊，带着他的大臣呢，带着他所有的一行人员，就来到了Jagannath Puri来觐见主Jagannath.
And at that time, Ramananda Rai also came with him.
那么这会儿呢,
Ramananda Rai had already met Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when Lord Chaitanya was in South India. So when Ramananda Rai came to Jagannath Puri, after seeing the deities, he went to see Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢,当, Ramananda Rai 去了庙里觐见了主Jagannath之后呢，他就去参拜Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And he offered his obeisances, and Lord Chaitanya embraced him, and they both began to cry in love, ecstasy, ecstatic love.
然后呢，他就顶拜了Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢热烈的拥抱了他，之后呢，他们俩人就在
Remember, Ramananda Rai is in Krishna Lila, he was the gopi Vishakha. who is the very best, very best friend of Radharani.
我们要知道，在 Sri Krishna 的逍遥时光中 ，Ramana Narayan 他是Vishakha Gopi， 所以呢，他是 Sri Madhurani 的非常要好的女伴。
So Lord Chaitanya enjoyed intimate association with Ramananda Roy.
所以说呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就非常享受和 Ramananda Roy 之间的很亲密的联谊。
But when all the other devotees, when they saw how Lord Chaitanya was so affectionate to Ramananda Roy, all the other devotees were surprised because they'd never seen Ramananda Roy before.
那么当所有的这些奉献者们看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Roy 之间的如此亲密的交流的时候呢，就感到非常的惊讶，因为奉献者们以前从来没有见过 Ramananda Roy。
Some of them who were there from Jagannath Puri, they knew Ramananda Roy, but they didn't know that he knew Lord Chaitanya, and they were surprised to see that they were so affectionate to each other.
那在 Jagannath Puri 的有些奉献者，虽然他们认识 Ramananda Roy, 但他们并不知道 Ramananda Roy 和 Sri Krishna, 认识，而且呢，他们之间是有如此亲密的这种交流。
When Lord Chaitanya had met Ramananda Roy in South India, they talked for a long time and discussed the pastimes of Lord Krishna, and Lord Chaitanya was so happy with Ramananda Roy.
当 Ramananda Roy 和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在南印度相见的时候呢，他们聊了很长的时间，都在聊关于 Sri Krishna 在就是当年 Sri Krishna 的逍遥时光的这个话题，所以当时呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就非常的被 Ramananda Roy 所取悦。
Because Ramananda Roy knew all of the scriptures, he'd learned everything, all the philosophy, he knew everything about the pastimes of Krishna and the gopis and the different ecstasies of love.
因为 Ramananda Roy 呢，他是饱读经书，而且呢，他是了解 Sri。Krishna 的所有的这些逍遥时光，以及呢，知道他们的各种爱以及各种极乐的那种展示。
So Lord Chaitanya told Ramananda Roy, he said, you know, he said, just now I'm traveling in South India, but when I finish my travels, I'm going back to Jagannath Puri, and I'll stay there. And he said, I want you to come and stay there with me.
所以呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Ramananda Roy 说呢，我现在呢是在南印度旅行，等我旅行完了以后呢，我就会回到 Jagannath Puri， 会定居在那里。到时候呢，我希望你能够来到 Jagannath Puri 和我一起住。
At this time, Ramananda Roy was the governor of this region of South India. He was governing a whole region on behalf of the king of Jagannath Puri.
那么当时呢 ，Ramananda 的 Raman Ramananda Roy 的身份呢，就像是这个南印度这个地区的一个省长一样。那么他当时呢，是代表着 Jagannath Puri 的国王在治理那个南印度的那个地区。
But Lord Chaitanya told him, he said, "No, you give up that job. You come and stay with me in Jagannath Puri, and we'll talk about Krishna all day, every day."
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，不行，你得辞职。你得从这个地方去到 Jagannath Puri， 并且呢和我住在一起，然后一整天呢都要和我探讨关于 Krishna 的话题。
So Ramananda Roy agreed. So he'd come back and he talked to the king and he told the king what happened and he told the king, he said, I want to give up my job, I want to retire. So the king said, oh, okay, no problem. And he said, the king said, I'll give you a pension also.
然后呢 ，Ramananda Roy 呢，他就同意了，并且呢，他还去和国王禀报了这个事情。他向国王讲述了都发生了什么事情。他说呢，我不能再为你干了，我得要退休了，因为我要去和主在一起。那么当时呢，国王听到这个消息之后呢，他就同意了。他说，那好吧，那你就退休吧，而且我还会给你退休金。
Yeah, not with God.不是跟主在一起，跟主 Chaitanya 在一起 ，right？
哦，就是我跟主 Chaitanya 在一起。
Because Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, he's not coming before everyone as God. He's playing the part of the devotee.
Yeah, 主 Chaitanya 对不起，我刚才那个地方说的不是特别准，就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他显示在世人面前是一位 sannyasi 的形式，他并没有向所有人揭示他是主。
Right, so he told the king, I'm just going to stay at the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya and we'll talk about Krishna all time. So he asked the king, please give me permission, and the king gave permission.
所以呢，他就对国王说呢，他说我呢要去陪伴 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的莲花族，然后呢，我们整天都要探讨关于主的逍遥时光。所以呢，请你给我允许，我就允许我退休，然后呢，主就允许他退休了。
The king was so actually very pleased, and when he heard the name of Lord Chaitanya, he stood up and he came and he embraced Ramananda Rai.
事实上呢，当国王听到他这么说的时候，他是非常开心的。当他听到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的名字的时候，国王一下子站了起来，并且拥抱了 Ramananda Rai.
As soon as he heard the name of Lord Chaitanya, his love awakened.And he took hold of the hand of Lord Chaitanya, of Ramananda Rai, and showed how much love he had.
那所以说呢，当他一听到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这个名字的时候，他内心的爱一下子就唤醒了。然后呢，他一下就抓住了 Ramananda Rai 的手，来展示着他有多少爱。
And for a pension, he said, "You can keep your salary. Keep you the same salary which you're getting just now."You can keep that every month, we'll pay you. And he said, don't have any anxiety. I want you to be without any anxiety.
而且国王给他付的这个退休金呢，和他现在在职的时候所每月拿到这个工资是一样多的。然后国王就对他说，你不要有任何的焦虑，那我会原数的付给你这个工资，不要有任何的焦虑。
And then the king said to Ramananda Rai, he said, no, I'm very fallen. I'm very abominable. I'm not fit to get an interview with Lord Chaitanya.
然后，国王就对 Ramananda Rai 说呢，说我非常的堕落，而且我也非常的可耻，所以说呢，我没有任何的资格去见 Sri Chaitanya.
This Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the son of Nanda Maharaj, and he is very merciful.
这位 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他是 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子，他非常的仁慈。
I can only hope that in some future birth, he will give me a chance to meet him.
我只希望在将来的某一个生世，他能够给我让我觐见他的机会。
So Ramananda Rai told Lord Chaitanya, he said, I don't think I have even a fraction of the love which Maharaj Prataparudra has.
然后呢 ，Ramananda Rai 就对 Ramananda Rai speak to Lord Chaitanya, right?
This is Ramananda Rai speaking to Lord Chaitanya.
Okay. 然后呢 ，Ramananda Rai 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就说呢，说我担心呐，我可能那就是就是连啊 Pataparudra 王他所具备的这一丁点爱都没有。
But Lord Chaitanya says to Ramananda Rai, he said, "You are the best of all the devotees of Krishna."
但是呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Ramananda Rai 说呢，你是 Sri Krishna 的所有的奉献者中最棒的那位奉献者。
Whoever, if somebody loves you, then they're a very fortunate person.
如果要是，爱你的这个人呢，就展示着这个人是非常非常幸运的。
So because the king showed so much love for you.Lord Krishna will certainly accept him.
但是，所以呢，因为这位国王展示了对你的这么多的爱，所以说呢，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，毫无疑问就能够接受这位国王了。
So when Ramananda Rai is telling Lord Chaitanya about the king, then this is helping to soften the heart of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以说呢，当 Ramananda Rai 向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 讲述这位国王的这些事情的时候呢，就使得 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的心变得柔软了下来。
And when he heard how the king gave a full salary to Ramananda Rai and encouraged him to retire and to spend his time with Lord Chaitanya, then this was also very encouraging for Lord Chaitanya to hear.
而且呢，当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到了 Ramananda Roy 对他说，嗯，这位国王全数付给他退休金，而且还鼓励他来见主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候，这对于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是很受鼓舞的听到的信息。
And Lord Chaitanya said, if somebody loves Ramananda Roy, then it's very good for that means that they'll get the blessings of Lord Krishna.
然后是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，爱 Ramananda Roy 的人，使这个人能够得到 Sri Krishna 的祝福。
Prabhupada quotes a saying which they have in the Western countries, you know.In the Western countries, people often have a dog. And so the person may say, if you love me, love my dog.
然后圣爸爸在这儿就引述了一个西方人经常会说的话，西方人会这么说，如果你要是爱我的话，你就得爱我的狗，就咱们说的爱屋及乌。
So if we want to go to Krishna, we have to go through his very confidential devotees.
所以如果我们要是想去到 Krishna 那儿的话呢，我们就必须要通过是 Krishna 的非常机密的同游奉献者。
So Lord Chaitanya is saying, because the king loves you, so Ramananda Roy is very fortunate, and Krishna will give the blessings to the king.
那所以呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就说，因为这位国王爱Ramananda Roy, 所以呢他非常的幸运。而且他就能够得到 Sri Krishna 对他的祝福。
There's a famous statement in the scriptures which says that Krishna says to Arjuna, if somebody said he's my devotee, actually he's not my devotee.
有这样一个非常著名的 Krishna 对 Arjuna 所说的宣言，就是说，宣称是我的奉献者的人，他并不是我的奉献者。
But somebody is a devotee of my devotees, then they are actually my devotees.
但是如果某人他说他是我的奉献者的奉献者，他就的确是我的奉献者。
So we want to approach Krishna, we have to go through his devotees.
所以如果我们要是想接近 Krishna 的话呢，我们就必须要。
Because the devotees, the confidential devotees of Krishna, they will take a lot of care and they have a lot of respect in their service to Krishna. So they use all their energy in their bodies for the service of Krishna.
他们会完全的运用他们的躯体以及他们的能量去服务 Krishna。
When they're speaking, they will glorify Krishna's qualities and forms.
当他们在讲话的时候呢，他们会荣耀 Sri Krishna 的形象以及他的forms and
quality,
他的行动。
Qualities, yeah.
他的品质，他的形象。
And so their minds are always fixed on trying to serve Krishna.
So, then, these 奉献者们他们的心意总是时刻都专注在要服务 Krishna 的这个事情上。
To give up all material desires.
他们放弃了所有的物质的欲望。
And there's a famous verse also where Lord Shiva is speaking to his wife Durga, and he's telling her. That the best type of worship is the worship of Lord Vishnu.
然后呢，还有一个非常著名的诗节是主希瓦对他的妻子 Durga 女神讲的。他说呢，最棒的崇拜是崇拜主 Vishnu.
In the Vedas, they often talk about the worship of demigods, but then they also say that the best worship is the worship of Vishnu.
在《韦达经》里面呢，就讲述了很多关于崇拜半神的话题，但是也说到了最棒，就是这个最杰出的崇拜是崇拜主 Vishnu。
But even greater than the worship of Vishnu is to give worship or to give service to the devotees who are connected to Lord Vishnu。
但是呢，比崇拜主 Vishnu 更好的是崇拜与 Vishnu 相连接在一起的主 Vishnu 的奉献者们。
So we see that in this case, that if by the mercy of Ramananda Rai, if you get please Ramananda Rai, then it's easier to approach Krishna.
所以在这里我们就看到了，如果我们要是取悦了 Ramananda Rai, 得到了 Ramananda Rai 的仁慈的话，那就更加的容易能够接近 Krishna.
Ramananda Rai is the intimate associate of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is actually Krishna.
Ramananda Roy 他是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 非常亲密的同游，那 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他其实就是 Sri Krishna。
So we want to meet with Lord Chaitanya. The king wants to meet with Lord Chaitanya. It's good that he is able to, first of all, please all the devotees. And by the blessings of all the devotees, then he will be able to meet with Krishna.
所以说呢，这位国王因为他想见到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 那所以在之前呢，他就最好是先取悦主的奉献者们，然后呢，在主的奉献者的祝福之下，使得他能够得到 Sri Krishna 的仁慈。
But if somebody's not very austere, then they won't be able to get the mercy of the pure devotees.
但是如果我们要是不能够做苦行的话，那我们是没有办法得到主的纯粹的奉献者的仁慈的。
The pure devotees will engage in 100% to worship Krishna.
因为一位纯粹的奉献者，他是100%的在从事着崇拜 Sri Krishna 的活动。
So when Lord Chaitanya was speaking like this about the king, when he was speaking with hearing from Ramananda Roy, at that time, many other devotees were also there.
所以呢，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在见到 Ramananda Roy 在这么讲述关于这国王的这个话题的时候呢，当时还有很多其他的奉献者也都在场。
Actually, there were four spiritual masters present.When he was meeting with Lord Chaitanya.
当他在见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候呢，当时在场还有四位灵性导师。
Right, they were all like, they were god brothers of the guru of Lord Chaitanya.
这四位灵性导师呢，都是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的灵性导师的神兄弟们。
Right, there were people, the names were, well, Lord Nityananda was there, and Swarup Damodar, and Paramananda Puri, and Brahmananda Bharati.
那有是主尼提安南达，还有
Paramananda Puri.
Paramananda Puri, 还有Brahmananda Bharati, 还有一位是 Swarup Damodar.
Yes, Swarup Damodar.So Ramananda Rai offered obeisances to all these people.
所以说呢 ，Ramananda Rai 呢就向所有的这四位灵性导师顶礼。
And then Lord Chaitanya asked Ramananda Rai, he said, "Have you been to the temple yet to see Lord Jagannath?"
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就问 Ramananda Rai, 你有没有去到庙里去见过主 Jagannath 了？
So Ramananda Rai said, well, I'm going to go now. I'll go now and visit the temple.
然后呢 ,Ramananda Rai 说呢，我现在就要去庙里。
So Lord Chaitanya said to him, and said, why did you come to see me first? Why didn't you go and see Lord Jagannath first and then come and see me?
然后呢 ,Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就说，你为什么要先来见我呢？你为什么不先去见主 Jagannath, 然后才来见我呢？
But Ramananda Rai said, well, my legs are just like the chariot.
Ramananda Rai 说呢，我的这双腿就好像是这辆战车。
And the heart, that's like the charioteer.
那我的心呢，就像是战车的御者。
So wherever the heart takes me, I have to go there.
所以呢，我的心所带我去到的地方，我就必须得到那个地方去。
Right? Krishna is in the heart.Of all living entities, and he directs us.
因为 Krishna 他在所有的奉献者的在因为 Krishna 他在所有的生物体的内心之中，他在指导着我们。
Of course, we're like the passenger on the chariot of the body. The body's like the chariot, and the living entity is like the passenger.
那当然呢，我们呢就像是这个身体之车的，这个过就是这个身体之车的这个旅客。那我们的这个身体呢是这个车子，而这个生物体呢，这个灵魂是这个车子上的旅客。
The intelligence is like the driver of the chariot.
我们的智性呢，就像是这个车夫驾驶这个车子的人。
And the mind is like the reins controlling the horses.
然后这个心意呢，就像是这个缰绳，它在控制着这些马。
And the senses are the horses.
而这感官呢，是这些马匹。
So if somebody is actually advanced in Krishna consciousness,They can control the mind and intelligence.
那所以一个在 Krishna 知觉中真正的处于 Krishna 知觉中的人呢，他是能够控制住他的心意和感官的。
And they use the mind and intelligence to control the senses.
他们会用他们的这个心意去控制感官。
And then it's very easy to approach Krishna.
那这样做到以后呢，就能够很容易的接近 Krishna 了。
Because that is the goal of life.
因为这是生命的目的地。
So people who are a little advanced, they will approach the Supreme Lord.
所以说呢，当人他有点进步的时候呢，他就会去接近至尊主公。
They shouldn't get attracted by the material energy.
他不应该被这物质的能量所吸引。
So Ramananda Rai said, he said, what shall I do? My mind brought me here.
So Ramananda Rai 说呢，我能怎么办呢？是我的心意把我给带到这儿来的。
I never thought about going first to see Lord Jagannath.
我从来就没有想过我要先去见主 Jagannath.
So Lord Chaitanya said, immediately go and see Lord Jagannath. Then go home and meet your family.
然后是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对他说呢，那你现在立刻去见主 Jagannath， 然后呢，你要回家去见见你的家人。
So then, with Lord Chaitanya's permission, Ramananda Rai went to see Lord Jagannath.
所以呢，在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的允许之下 ，Ramananda Rai 去到了庙里见Sri Jagannath.
It's not easy to understand the devotional service of a great devotee like.Ramananda Rai.
理解像 Ramananda Rai 的这样一位非常伟大的奉献者的奉爱服务之情并不容易。
So when the king came back to Jagannath Puri, then he called for the Bhattacharya. He wants to see him.
所以说呢，当国王他来到 Jagannath Puri 之后呢，他就召见 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya， 他想见他。
So he asked him. He said, "Did you?" Tell Lord Chaitanya I wanted to meet him.
所以呢，他就问 Bhattacharya， 问他你有没有跟 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 讲呢？我想见他。
And Bhattacharya said, "Well, yeah, I tried to tell him."
然后 Bhattacharya 说，我试着跟他说了。
But he wouldn't agree. He doesn't want to see a king.
但是呢，他不同意，他不想见国王。
And he said, if I ask him again, he said he's going to leave Jagannath Puri and go some other place to live.
而且他说，如果我要是再向他提出这个请求的话，他就会离开 Jagannath Puri 到别地儿去住了。
So when the king heard this, he was very sorry. He felt very sad.
所以当国王听到这一消息之后呢，他就感到非常的悲伤。
And the king said, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.He has come to deliver all the sinful people. He delivered sinners, sinful people like Jagai and Madai were delivered by him.
他说呢，这位Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他来到这里是为了要解救所有的有罪之人，就连像 Jagai 和 Madai 这样的罪人都被他给解救了。
He's come to deliver all the sinners except for this king.Named Maharaj Prataparudra, which was his name.
他说呢，他来到这里解救所有的人，除了这位被称为叫Prataparudra Mahar 的国王，这位 Maharaj Prataparudra 就这国王自己的名字。
So Maharaj Prataparudra considered himself very fallen and very unfortunate.
所以呢, Prataparudra 王呢, 就觉得自己非常的不幸, 非常的堕落。
He had to deal with many material things.
因为他确实需要去处理很多的物质的事物。
And he had to enjoy all kinds of material luxuries.
而且呢, 他要享受各种各样的物质的奢华的物品。
But he was surrendered to Krishna.
但是呢, 他是归依于 Krishna的。
So actually Lord Chaitanya could not refuse him.
所以说实际上, 主Chaitanya妈妈不是没有办法拒绝他的。
We couldn't really say he was a materialistic person. He wasn't. The king said, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decided he will deliver everyone except for me. Is that what he's decided?
那么这位国王就说，那么主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他决定要拯救所有的人除了我之外，这是他做出的决定吗？
He looks upon all kinds of low-class people. He will cast his glance over all kinds of low-class people who are never even usually seen. But he will put his glance of mercy over them and deliver them.
就是他呢会把他仁慈的瞥视，照见所有的这些非常低等的生物体。 哪怕那些以前从来没有被人所看到过的那些生物体，他都会把他仁慈的瞥视赐予他们。So
the king said, if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not going to see me, then I'm going to give up my life if I do not get to see him.
然后呢，这位国王就说，如果要是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他不同意见我的话，那我就只能自行了断我的生命了。
So this is a very nice example of determination.
所以这是一个关于决心的非常好的榜样。
We have to have a lot of determination to practice Krishna consciousness.
所以为了要修习Krishna知觉，我们必须要有很强的决心。
There can be so many obstacles, so many problems in practicing Krishna consciousness.
我们在修习Krishna知觉的时候呢，可能会遇到很多障碍，会遇到很多麻烦。And
we have to be determined to go on despite all the problems.
所以说呢，虽然说我们可能会经历这样的各种各样的麻烦，但是我们要非常的坚决的要继续下去。Right,
this is described in the Bhagavad Gita also, that you have to make this kind of vow, you have to have this vow that you're going to continue to practice Krishna
consciousness.
Yeah, the word in Sanskrit is dridha vrat. Vrata means a vow, and dridha means very determined that you're going to do this.
那么在梵文里面的这个被称为叫 Drita Vat 的意思呢是誓言 Drita 的意思呢是非常坚定的就是要非常的坚定的去信守这个誓言
Yeah, you can find this word in the 7th chapter, text number 28 where Lord Krishna describes qualification for taking up devotional service
这个词呢我们可以在圣典不加梵歌的第七章的第28节里面找到 那么这里面呢，Sri Krishna他就在描述着要想进行婚外服务的时候需要具备的品质。
And then it comes again in the 9th chapter, text number 14.
然后呢，在圣典不加梵歌的第9章的第14节里面也有这个词。
Where devotees, mahatmas are described, that they're always endeavoring with great determination.
那么在这个世界里面呢，就描述了Mahatma这样伟大的奉献者，他们总是怀着心坚意愿的决心。So
unless we have that determination, we won't be able to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
所以，除非我们有这样的决心，否则我们是没有办法得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈的。
So the king is a very nice example. He's really determined. He says, I'm ready to give up my life.
所以说呢，国王就给我们树立了一个非常好的榜样，他是非常的坚决的。我如果是见不到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 那我就要自杀。
Just like Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada, he wanted to get initiation from Gaurakishore Das Babaji.
那么就好像Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada，他想从 Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj 那里得到启迪。
So Gaurakishore Das Babaji didn't have any disciples. He didn't want to initiate anyone.
但是 Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj 呢，他没有任何的门徒，他也不想启迪任何人。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati asked him, and he said, "Well, I'll ask Krishna. See what Krishna says." And after some time, he said, "Did you ask Krishna?" He said, "No, he didn't reply anything yet." And so finally, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati said he's going to give up his life unless he gets the initiation.
所以呢，是 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 他个人呢，就向 Babaji Maharaj 请求得到启迪。然后呢 ，Babaji Maharaj 就说，那我得问问 Krishna 是怎么跟我说的。然后就这么经过几次之后呢。Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 他会问 Babaji Maharaj 他的回应是什么， Babaji Maharaj 就说我还没有从 Sri Krishna 那儿得到任何的回应。然后最后 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 他会就说，如果我要是没有从您这儿得到启迪的话，那我只能自杀了，只能放弃我自己的生命。
So when Gaurakishore Das Babaji heard this, then he said, oh, all right, then okay, we will give you initiation.
所以当 Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj 听到这个话的时候，他就说道，那好吧，那我给你起立。
So, we see also in the Bhagavad Gita, example of determination is there. The sparrow lost her eggs in the ocean.
我们在国家梵歌里面还看到了一个关于决心的例子，就这个小麻雀，它的雀蛋被海水给卷走了。
So the little bird was going to drink the ocean dry to get back her eggs.
对呢，这小鸟儿它就要把整个的海水都给喝掉，然后从而得回它自己的雀蛋。
And then Garuda came and told the ocean, "Give the bird back her eggs, or I will drink you dry."
然后这样呢，就吸引来了 Garuda 大鸟，然后 Garuda 大鸟就对海洋说。你把麻雀的蛋还给他，否则的话我就喝光你的水。
So we have to be very determined. We want to become Krishna conscious. We have to really make efforts.
所以说呢，我们就必须要非常坚定的让自己，具有 Krishna 知觉。如果我们要享有 Krishna 知觉的话，我们就必须要付出努力。
So the king said, "If I don't get to receive Lord Chaitanya's mercy,then my body and my kingdom are useless."
所以国王就说，如果我是得不到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈的话，那我的躯体以及我的王国都是毫无用处的。
Now, if we don't get the mercy of Krishna, then what is the good of anything else?
如果我要是得不到 Krishna 的仁慈的话，其他的一切又有什么用呢？
So we have to be.We have to really search out to understand properly spiritual life and to make proper use of everything in Krishna's service.
那所以说呢，我们就必须要好好的探寻，非常好的去理解什么是灵性生活，然后呢，以最佳的方式把所有的一切用在对 Sri Krishna 的服务中。
So Bhattacharya was very surprised to hear the king and to see that he was so determined.
那所以呢，巴德查人他就非常的惊讶的听着Sri Krishna国王的这一席话，以及非常惊叹的看着国王所具备的这种决心。
The king had all kinds of facility for material enjoyment, but he didn't want them. He wanted Krishna's mercy.
国王他有各种各样的享受物质快乐的设施。但是呢，他不想要这些物质的条件的设施，他想要的是 Krishna 的仁慈。
He just wanted to see Lord Chaitanya.
他只是想见到主 Chaitanya.
So, devotional service should not be conditional. We shouldn't have any conditions on our service to Krishna.
所以说奉爱服务是不应该设任何条件的。当我们在服务 Krishna 的时候，就不要设限。
We give service to Krishna, it shouldn't depend on our material position.
而且呢，我们也不应该凭借我们的物质的处在物质的位置去服务 Krishna.
It should be, devotional service can be done by anyone in any position.
奉爱服务是可以被任何人去做的，无论这个人他处在怎样的位置。
We cannot tell somebody, oh, you're not qualified, you cannot be a devotee, you go away. We never tell like that. But you have to be very determined to become devotee.
但是呢，我们要想成为奉献者，我们就必须要非常的坚决。
So the Bhattacharya told the king, he said, don't worry, he said, because you're so determined, I'm sure Lord Chaitanya will give his mercy to you.
然后Bhattacharya就对国王说，你不用担心，因为你如此的坚决，所以我相信主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu一定是会把他的仁慈给你的。
By the mercy of the spiritual master, you get the mercy of Krishna.
在灵性导师的仁慈之下，我们得到了Krishna的仁慈。So
the Bhattacharya, he was the spiritual master of the king.
那么Bhattacharya呢，他是国王的灵性导师。So
he was giving his blessings to the king, that Lord Chaitanya would be merciful to him.
所以呢，他就祝福了国王，那么Chaitanya，他祝福Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu会把仁慈给他。
So the king also had faith in the Bhattacharya. He accepted that this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he must be Krishna, he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And so he began, that's why he began to be so anxious to meet with them. Lord Chaitanya.
那也就这个原因呢，使得这位国王他如此焦灼的想要见到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So we have to be convinced by the spiritual master that Krishna is God.
那所以呢，我们呢必须要被我们的灵性导师所说服，说服 Krishna 就是神.
And then we can make more advancement by thinking about Krishna and chanting his name and worshipping him.
然后这样呢，我们就可以通过想着 Krishna 念诵他的圣名，崇拜他，而取得更高的进步。
And in this way, we'll go on to get the real mercy of Krishna.
那以这样的方式，我们不断的前行，就能够得到Sri Krishna 的真正的仁慈。
So Bhattacharya told Lord Chaitanya, Krishna is only approached by pure love.
Bhattacharya 对国王说的，就是 Krishna 他只有
Lord Chaitanya, the Bhattacharya told the king that your love for Lord Chaitanya is very deep. There's no doubt he will be merciful to you.
然后呢，Bhattacharya对国王说，你对Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的这个爱是非常的深沉的，所以说呢，这是毫无疑问的，所以他一定会对你仁慈。
So, it's the duty of the disciple to follow the order of the spiritual master.
作为一位门徒，他要履行的职责是追随灵性导师的训谕。Then
certainly, by the mercy of the spiritual master, we get the mercy of Krishna.
那毫无疑问，在灵性导师的仁慈之下，他就能够得到Krishna的仁慈。
So then the Bhattacharya said to the king, there is one way by which you can actually directly see Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，Bhattacharya就对国王说呢，其实有一个方式，你能够直接见到主Chaitanya。
He said, on the day of the festival of Rathyatra, Lord Chaitanya will dance before the deity in great love.
他说呢，在弹车节的这一天呢，主 Chaitanya 他会在神像面前怀着极大的爱意翩翩起舞。
So after dancing in the Rath Yatra, then all the devotees headed by Lord Chaitanya, they will go into the Gundicha garden, which is just beside the Gundicha temple.
然后呢，在跳完舞之后呢，所有的这些奉献者在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的引领之下，一路会去到Gundicha 花园。Gundicha 花园就在 Gundicha 庙的旁边。
So at that time, you should go there.But don't go like a king. Take off your king's dress and put on the dress of an ordinary devotee.
然后这会儿呢，你就应该去到那里。但你去的时候呢，你不要打扮成国王的样子，你要穿上普通人的便装。
And when Lord Chaitanya comes there, then you should go there, and you should read the.Five chapters of the Srimad Bhagavatam about Krishna dancing with the gopis.
然后呢，等你到了那儿，等当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到那儿的时候，你也应该去那儿。然后你要在那儿诵读圣殿国家瓦坛里关于 Sri Krishna 和 Gopi 们一起跳舞的那五章的内容。
And at that time, you can also give Lord Chaitanya massage. You can massage his lotus feet.
在那会儿的时候呢，你也可以为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 按摩他的莲花足。
And I'm sure at that time Lord Chaitanya, because he's been dancing in the Rath Yatra, so his mood, his bhava will be awakened. He will be in ecstasy, so he won't have much. He won't have any consciousness of what's going on around him.
那我相信在那会儿，由于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他在。这个弹车面前跳舞，然后这会儿呢，他内心的 bug 已经被唤醒了，所以呢，他可能就会处在一种很沉醉的状态，以至于他就不会非常的清楚周边发生了什么。
And at that time, you recite the Srimad Bhagavatam, those chapters which I told you.
在那会儿呢，你就去诵读圣殿国家瓦坛里面的那些我刚才让你去读的那些章节。
And when he hears it, he will be so happy.He will embrace you. He will know you are a pure devotee.
在那会儿，他就会非常的开心，他就会拥抱你，并且他会知道你是一位纯粹的奉献者。
So, we will hear later on how the king comes and he recites from the chapter called the Gopi Gita, the songs by the Gopi.
那所以我们后面呢就会听到。如何主来了以后呢，这位国王他在诵读着国家瓦坛里面的这部分内容，这部分内容呢被称为叫 Gopi Gita， 就是由 Gopi 们所唱诵的歌， Gopi 之歌。
Usually in the month of Kartik, many temples they're reciting that chapter.
通常来说呢，就是在卡提卡月的时候，很多庙里的奉献者们他们都会唱这首歌。
It's not a very big chapter. There's only 19 verses.
这个并不是很长的一个章节，一共只有19个时节。
But it's very beautiful, and when the devotees sing it, it's so nice.
但是呢，非常的动听。当奉献者们在歌唱这首歌的时候，是非常的动听的，非常的美妙的。
So it happened when Lord Chaitanya was dancing, the king came and he recited, and Lord Chaitanya became so happy.
And so, 呢，就当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 在跳舞的时候呢，这位国王他就唱诵了这首 Gopi Gita 之歌，然后呢，当时 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就非常的开心。
So this is the mercy of the Bhattacharya. He's a devotee.And he wants to help another devotee. He wants to help the king, who is also a devotee. He wants to help him to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
So, 呢，这就是 Bhattacharya 的仁慈。Bhattacharya 他是一位奉献者，那他想帮助另外一位奉献者。他想帮助这位国王。这位国王也是一位奉献者。他想帮助这位是国王的奉献者能够得到主的仁慈。
So he knows the king is very sincere.So he wants to help the king to get that mercy.
而且呢，他也知道这位国王是非常的真诚的，所以呢，他就希望能够帮助这位国王能够得到仁慈。
Actually, Lord Chaitanya had already changed his mind about the king because he'd heard so many good things about the king from Ramananda Roy.
事实上呢，主柴坦尼亚马哈布已经对这位国王转变心意了，因为他从 Ramananda Roy 那里面听到了很多的关于这位国王的美言。
In the beginning, he didn't want to meet the king, but later on, after hearing about the king from Ramananda Roy and then from the Bhattacharya, then he understood, well, the king is not so materialistic, he's actually a devotee.
那在最开始的时候呢，他是不想见这位国王的，但是由于他听到了从 Ramananda Roy 还有Bhattacharya 那里太多的关于这位国王的美妙的品质，所以呢，他就能够明白这位国王他是一位真的奉献者，并不是一位物质主义者。
So through the mercy of the devotee, Krishna is satisfied.
所以说呢，在 Krishna is satisfied. 所以说在这个奉献者的仁慈之下，使得 Krishna 感到心满意足了。
So we have to get the dust from the devotee's feet.
所以说呢，我们就必须要得到一位奉献者莲花足上的尘土。
And this helps us to get the mercy of Krishna.
因为这个莲花足上的尘土呢，能够帮助我们得到是 Krishna 的仁慈。
And so we have to go through the pure devotees. We cannot go directly to Krishna. We have to go through his devotees.
所以说呢，我们要想见到 Krishna， 我们不能够直接去找他，我们必须要通。
So we see the king, even you're a king like Maharaj Prataparudra, he's worshipping Ramananda Roy, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and by their mercy, he gets to meet with Lord Chaitanya.
So we can see that through this king, Prataparudra Maharaj, he worships Ramananda Roy, he worships Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.从而使得他能够得到主的，在他们的仁慈之下，使得他得到了主的仁慈。
So, when the king heard all of this from the Bhattacharya, he agreed to wait and to follow his instructions.
So much. Could you say it again?
When the king heard Bhattacharya speaking all like this.He had, you know, Bhattacharya gave the plan that we'll wait until Rathiyatra, at that time you can go and meet him. So the king decided that sounds like a good idea, we'll do like that.
So, 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 so,
so, at this time,They had not even had the bathing ceremony of this is before the Rathiyatra, so there were still three more days before the bath of Lord Jagannath.
但是这件事情的发生呢，是在弹车节发生的三天之前所发生的事情，所以说呢，就在这会儿还没有给主 Jagannath 沐浴呢。
Yeah, the bathing ceremony is called the Snan Yatra. Snan means the bath, and Yatra, the journey. The
那这个沐浴的仪式呢，被称为叫 Snan Yatra. Snan 的意思呢，就是沐浴 ，Snan Yatra， 沐浴仪式。
So on the day.Okay, now it comes to the day of the bathing ceremony. Lord Chaitanya is very happy. He likes to see the bathing of Lord Jagannath.
So, 说在沐浴仪式这一天呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是非常开心的，因为他喜欢看着主 Jagannath 被沐浴。
The deities, of course, in Jagannath Puri, they're very big, so very difficult to bathe. It needs a lot of.Substance, a lot of water and milk and ghee.
当然了，在 Jagannath Puri 的这个 Jagannath 神像是非常巨大的，所以说呢，给神像沐浴并不是一件很容易的事情，是需要有很多的这个物品的，比如说很多的水呀，很多的酸奶呀，很多的酥油啊，来给神像沐浴。
So Lord Chaitanya was very happy for the bathing ceremony, but then after the bathing ceremony, then Lord Jagannath retires, and we don't see Lord Jagannath for 2 weeks.
然后，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢是非常的开心的，能够参加这个沐浴仪式的。那么给主Jagannath沐完浴之后呢，主Jagannath就要先退出去了。那么在接下来的两周里面，大家是见不到Sri Chaitanya，见不到主Jagannath的。Because
after the bathing, then the Lord Jagannath and Baladev and Subhadra, they go in a special room, and they're not in the temple anymore, and it's like they're sick. And they're given special foodstuffs which the sick people would be given to help them recover.
因为在沐浴之后呢，主Jagannath、Subhadra还有主Baladev，他们都不会再回到他们之前的那个神像房的地方，他们会被送到另外一个房间里面，因为他们在沐浴之后呢就
And at that time also the deities are repainted, because with the bathing a lot of the paint comes off their bodies, so they're repainted after the bathing.
实际上呢，就在这段时间呢，要给所有的这些神像要重新的粉刷。
And so, because Lord Chaitanya couldn't see the deities anymore, he won't be able to see the deity for 2 weeks, so he became very unhappy.
所以说呢，在两个星期, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 都见不到神像，所以他就变得很生气，很伤心。
So at that time, Lord Chaitanya would leave Jagannath Puri and he'd go to another town, which is about 30 kilometers away, a place called Alanath. Just like when Krishna left Vrindavan, the gopis felt separation from Krishna. So in the same way, when Lord Jagannath is not on the altar, Lord Chaitanya feels separation from Krishna. Yeah, there's a nice temple in Alanath. It's a Vishnu temple, but although it's a Vishnu deity, the deity is worshipped with Krishna mantras. Yeah, they say that just like when Krishna was hiding from the gopis, at one point he took the form of Lord Vishnu. So when the gopis came running looking for Krishna, they only saw Lord Vishnu. So they offered their obeisances to Lord Vishnu. And then they asked him, did you see Lord Krishna? But when Srimati Radharani came there, then Lord Krishna could not disguise himself, and he had to reveal himself in the two-armed form.
Krishna
had been hiding, he took the four-armed form, to hide from the gopis, but when Radharani came, he could not hide himself from her. So Lord Chaitanya would go to this temple at Alanath and he would feel ecstasy there in that temple. And you can see on the floor, you can see parts of the floor where the stone melted due to the contact of Lord Chaitanya's body.
然后呢，我们可以就是在这个庙里的这个地板上看到有这么一个被化掉的这么一个形象，这形象就是由于Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的这个身体在这上面，而是这个地方化了下，化掉了。So
Lord Chaitanya was staying there at Alanath, and you know, he was waiting for the time when Lord Jagannath would come back on the altar.
所以说呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他就会在阿瓦那这个地方等待着主 Jagannath 还有其他的神像回到他们的神坛上。But
at a certain point, all the devotees came from Jagannath Puri, and they told him. They said, "You have to come back now because all the devotees are coming from Bengal, and they're all coming to see you. So you have to be there to greet them."
就在这中间有段时间呢，所有的Jagannath Puri的这个奉献者就跑到阿瓦那来找Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，对他说：“您现在您必须得赶紧回到Jagannath Puri去了，因为孟加拉的所有的这些奉献者全都来了，要来见您，要拜见您，所以这会儿您必须得回去见他们。”
So then, Lord Chaitanya came back to Jagannath Puri, and the king was happy, and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is happy that Lord Chaitanya's come back.
所以呢，主，Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢就回到了Jagannath Puri，这会儿大家都开心了，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya也很开心，国王也非常开心，因为Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu回来了。So
when he got back to Jagannath Puri, he heard that 200 devotees are coming from Bengal, and they're all very very advanced devotees.
那么当他回到Jagannath Puri之后呢，他就听说，有200位奉献者从孟加拉来了，而且这200位奉献者都是非常精进的奉献者。They're
all great devotees. They're very devoted to Lord Chaitanya, and they're already here. They're already on the bank of Lake Narendra, and they're waiting there.
然后呢，他们都是非常伟大的奉献者。 而且呢，都非常的奉献于，就是对Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu有很深的奉爱之情。然后这些奉献者呢，他们现在已经到了Narendra河的河岸了，已经在那儿在等待着了。And
he said they're waiting. They don't have anywhere to stay yet. They didn't get any prasadam yet.
而且呢，他们在这儿等着，他们不知道在哪里居住，而且他们还没有荣耀prasadam。
So when the king heard, he said, "All right, I will give orders. I will arrange everything. We will arrange their places to stay, and we'll arrange prasadam, everything."
然后国王听到这话之后呢，就说：“好吧，我来安排所有的这一切。我会安排他们的住宿，我也会为他们安排prasadam。” So
then the king says to Sarvabhauma, he said, "I want you to show me all these devotees. Tell me who they are. They're all coming from Bengal. I want you to point them out to me."
然后国王就对Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya说呢，我想请您向我引荐所有的这些奉献者们，他们都是来自于孟加拉，他们在哪里，请您带我去见他们，我想见他们。So
they went up on the roof of the palace where they could see everyone.
所以呢，他们就登上了王宫的屋顶，然后呢，在这个屋顶上，他们就能够俯瞰一切，看到所有人。
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, he said, "Actually, I don't know them, but my cousin, Gopinath Acharya, he knows them, and he will tell us who they are."
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya他就对国王说呢，实际上我不认识这些奉献者，但是呢，我的表兄 Gopinath Acharya呢，他认识所有的这些奉献者们，所以我们请他来。 告诉我们每一位奉献者都是谁。
So they went up on the roof and they could see everyone, and they saw Swarup Damodar and Govinda. They brought flower garlands and prasadam and began to distribute to all the devotees.
然后呢，他们就看到所有的这些，然后呢，他们就在这个屋顶上看着这些奉献者们，然后他们就看到 Swarup Damodar 还有 Govinda 就已经向这些奉献者们派发 prasadam 了。
So Lord Chaitanya, he'd already sent these to Swarup Damodar and Govinda. He said, you go now, go and take flower garlands and give prasadam to devotees. So the king said, who are those two?
然后国王就问这俩人是谁。
So they said, well, this one, he is Swarup Damodar. He is like the second expansion of the body of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
然后他们就告诉国王说呢，这位是 Swarup Damodar， 他就好像是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身体的第二个扩展一样，的第二个身体。
Right. Lord Chaitanya, he comes in the mood of Radharani.
那么 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他是以 Sri Madhurani 的心态而来的。
And Swarup Damodar, he is actually the incarnation of, he is a form of Lalita, some say Lalita and others say Vishakha.
而 Swarup Damodar 呢，他是有些人说他是 Lalita 的扩展，有些人说他是 Vishakha 的扩展。
So he's very close to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以呢 ，Swarup Damodar 他是非常非常的亲近于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的。
And the other person is Govinda, and he's the personal servant of Lord Chaitanya.
而另外一个人呢是 Govinda， 他是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身边的贴身仆人。
So Lord Chaitanya sent his garland and he sent prasadam. He wants to honor all the devotees coming from Bengal.
所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，就通过他们送去了 prasadam 和花环，然后以这样的方式呢，来迎接和尊重招待这个来从孟加拉来的这些奉献者们。
So first he gave a garland to Advaita Acharya, and then Govinda came and he also gave another garland to Advaita Acharya.
首先呢，就他们先向 Advaita Acharya 献上了花环。然后 Govinda 也向 Advaita Acharya 献上了另外一串花环。
So then Govinda offered his obeisances to Advaita Acharya, and Advaita Acharya said, "Who is he? I don't know who is this."
然后呢 ，Govinda 呢就向 Advaita Acharya 顶拜，然后 Advaita Acharya 就问：“这是谁啊？我不认识他。
”And Swarup Damodar said, "Oh, he is the servant. He was the servant of Ishwara Puri, and." Ishwara Puri told him to come and serve Lord Chaitanya, and he's very qualified.
然后 Swarup Damodar 就对 Advaita Acharya 说呢，说他之前是 Ishwara Puri 的仆人，然后呢 Ishwara Puri 请他来这里服务主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 所以呢他是非常的有资格的。
So then the king said, well.Who did they give the, because the king didn't know anybody. He said, who was this person, Swarup Damodar and Govinda? They both gave garlands to. He was very effulgent. He must be a very great devotee. Who is he?
那然后因为这位国王呢，他谁都不认识，所以呢，他就问到，这个由 Swarup Damodar 和 Govinda 献上花环的这位人是谁啊？他看起来是充满了光芒。他一定是一位非常伟大的奉献者。他是谁呀、
啊、？So this is Advaita Acharya, and Advaita Acharya, he's honored by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so he's the topmost devotee.
然后回答说呢，这位是 Advaita Acharya. Advaita Acharya 被 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所敬重，他是最高级的伟大的奉献者了。
Yeah, Lord Chaitanya would always think of Advaita Acharya like his spiritual master. He would come and worship and offer obeisances and touch his feet.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是非常的敬重他的， 把他视为像是他自己的灵性导师一样，他会去顶拜他，并且会触摸他的莲花足。
Actually, Advaita Acharya was very much older than Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but Lord Chaitanya is Krishna, and Advaita Acharya wants to respect him.
事实上呢，从岁数上说呢 ，Advaita Acharya 要比 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 要年长很多。但是呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是 Sri Krishna 本人，所以 Advaita Acharya 呢有非常的尊重Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
So then the devotee tells the king the name of all the other devotees, all very great devotees.
然后呢，就是向国王一一的介绍着所有的这些奉献者的名字。
And then he points out there were three brothers. He said their sankirtan is so pleasing. Lord Chaitanya loves their kirtan so much.
然后还说到呢，这有三兄弟，这三兄弟呢，能够演唱非常动听的 kirtan， 他们的 kirtan 是非常取悦 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 非常的喜欢他们所唱的 kirtan。
So all of these devotees they were very effulgent, and they were doing kirtan. It was so nice. The king had never heard any such kirtan like what they were doing.
那么所有的这些奉献者们呢？都是充满着光彩的，而且呢，他们在唱诵着，非常极乐美妙的 kirtan。这位国王他以前从来没有经历过这样的 kirtan。
And the king could see how effulgent they were. He was just so surprised to see so many of these Vaishnavas and how they were so effulgent.
那么国王呢？他见到所有的这些奉献者所绽放出来的这种光灿是非常惊愕的。他从来就没有，经历过这么多的如此充满了光芒的奉献者们。
So the king could understand they were not on the bodily platform. They were all nitya siddha. They were liberated devotees.
所以说，国王他就明白，所有的这些奉献者们都不是处于躯体化概念的层面的奉献者，他们都是 Nitya Siddha， 他们都是永恒解脱了的灵魂。
So there were all the there were many people, different villages, people from different villages that all come there, and there were so many people. He said finally, he told the king, "There's so many names." He said, "I can't. How much can I tell you?"
然后呢？从各个村落里面都聚来了很多的人们，所有的人们都来了，所以呢，就有好多好多的人，所以他们就对国王说：“这有太多人了，我怎么能够给你点数的过来所有的这些人的名字呢？”
And said they're all associates of Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya is their life and soul.
所有的这些人呢，全部都是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的同游们。然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是他们的生命和灵魂。
So the king understood. He said, "Yeah, he said their effulgence is like, it's like a million suns."
然后国王他就说，的确，他们所绽放的光彩光芒就好像是有百万轮太阳所绽放的光芒一样。
And their kirtan sounds so beautiful. It's so attractive.
而且他们的 kirtan 实在是太美妙了，实在是太吸引人了。
So this is how to preach. You want to attract the materialistic people, nice kirtan, and bright smiling faces.
所以呢，这就是我们传教的方式。如果我们想要吸引物质主义者的话，我们就需要有非常动听的 kirtan 以及非常光鲜的笑容。
And Prabhupada also mentions it's nice if you can do dramas about the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya or Lord Krishna.
然后Srila Prabhupada 也曾经对我们说呢，如果我们要是能够演一些关于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 以及 Sri Krishna 的消时光的剧目，也是很好的。
Prabhupada liked the devotees that they could do like that, put on a drama to present Krishna's pastimes.
那所以呢，舍利巴巴他就喜欢看奉献者能够把这些消时光给搬上舞台，演成剧目。
So the king says, I've never seen so much ecstatic love, and I've never heard so much nice chanting.
然后这位国王他就说呢,我从来就没有见过,经历过这么极乐的爱,这么多的极乐的爱,以及听到过这么动听的kirtan.
And their dancing is also so wonderful. How they dance, oh, it's so beyond this world.
而且他们的舞姿也是非常的美妙的,他们的这种跳舞的这种方式, 根本就不是属于这个世界的人跳舞的方式。
So Prabhupada said this is the duty of the devotees of ISKCON also, to attract people by nice kirtan.
那所以说，Srila Prabhupada说呢, 作为奉献者以及ISKCON的职责都在于通过很美妙的kirtan来吸引人。
Just like the devotees of Lord Chaitanya, just like they attracted the attention of of the king of Puri. So devotees in ISKCON should attract the public by nice kirtan. So the Bhattacharya told the king, he said, yes, this kirtan, he said, this is a special creation of Krishna. It's called Prema Sankirtan.
In
the Kali Yuga, the process of religion is through the Sankirtan, the chanting of the holy name. And if somebody is worshipping Lord Chaitanya by chanting, then he is very intelligent.
来崇拜水切坦尼亚马哈帕布的话,
and if somebody does not do this, then it should be understood that he has no good brain.
那如果要是这个人,就如果是没有这么做的这个人呢,
okay, so I think we'll stop here. We'll ask if there's any questions.
那我们的讲述这一部分呢，就先到这儿了。我们看看大家有没有任何的问题。Yes, Maharaj.
Okay.
The first question is from Sugita Sangha Mataji. Hare Krishna, Dingbai Guru Maharaj, 感恩您，感恩翻译，谢谢您。请问Guru, 卡利年代的我们做哪些活动算是苦行？ Maharaj, you got that? Mataji paid her humble obeisances to you. And she said that in the Kali Yuga, what kind of activities can be considered as the austerities?
Well, the austerity in the Kali Yuga is to follow four regulative principles and chant 16 rounds.
在卡利年代的苦行呢，是指我们念诵圣名，以及呢，就是念诵16圈，还有呢，遵循四项规范原则。
And it's a great austerity to also try to distribute books.
还有另外一个呢，就是如果我们要是努力的去派书的话，这也是一个很大的苦行。
If you're able to approach people who are like Jagai and Madhai, who are very sinful and very fallen, if you are able to approach them and preach to them, or give them Krishna consciousness, then that's a great austerity.
就如果我们要是能够去接近像加盖尔马代这样的人，因为他们是非常堕落的，而且呢是非常的罪恶的。就如果我们要是能够接近他们，并且呢努力把Krishna知觉给予他们的话，那这是一个非常大的苦行。But
if you want to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, you have to please Lord Nityananda.
但是如果你要是想得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈的话呢，你就必须要先得到主 Nityananda 的仁慈。
And Lord Nityananda, he is always trying to deliver the fallen souls who are like Jaggai and Madhai.
而主 Nityananda 呢，他总是在努力着要去解救堕落的灵魂，像加盖马代这样的堕落灵魂。
So if you take up this work, if you take up that work on behalf of Lord Nityananda to help him in that preaching work, then he will be very pleased to give his blessings to you.
所以如果我们要是能够从事这样的活动，去帮助朱尼天南的去做这样的传教的活动的话，那么他们就会非常的被取悦。
But even if you cannot do this kind of preaching work, if you can strictly follow the principles of Krishna consciousness, eating only Krishna prasadam and chanting the holy name, then that's a great austerity.
但是如果我们要是没有办法去进行传教的这个工作，但是我们如果是能够努力的让自己去遵守这些规范原则，仅仅去荣耀 Sri Krishna 的 prasadam 并且念诵圣名的话，这其实已经也是很了不起的苦行了。
Austerities are purifying.
苦行是很净化的。
There we see in the Bhagavad Gita there is austerity in the mode of goodness and passion and in ignorance.
那在《国家梵歌》里面，我们就知道，在苦行中呢，它其实也分在善良形态、激进形态以及愚昧形态下的苦行。
So we want to cultivate austerity in goodness, and that's austerity for the body and the mind and words.
那所以说呢，我们希望是在善良形态去培养我们的苦行，培养出对我们的这个身体、心理以及言语的苦行。
Austerity in words are speaking words which are pleasing and truthful.
那在言语中的苦行内就意味着是讲宜人的话以及讲真话。
And it's also if one recites the scriptures, that is also austerity in speaking.
还有呢，就是诵读经典，这也是在言语中的苦行。
And so Srila Prabhupada said,We should try to speak the truth in such a way that it is pleasing to others.
那所以说，爸爸说呢，我们就应该努力着让自己以一种宜人的方式去说话。
Of course, some people they may not like to hear the truth, and they may take offense.
当然有些人可能他不愿意听真话，而且他们也觉得是被冒犯了。
So you have to be very careful.
所以呢，我们必须要非常的小心。
Mm. Preaching to people, you want to be able to preach to people in a manner that you can make them more favorable to Krishna consciousness.
嗯，因为我们在向别人在传教的时候呢，我们是希望别人能够更加的，这个喜欢 Krishna。
One time, Srila Prabhupada was invited in.In a city in India, he was invited to give a lecture to a lot of big businessmen, very wealthy people. So Prabhupada gave a lecture from Srimad Bhagavatam.
那有一次呢，说爸爸就是到了印度的一个城市，那么在这城市呢，他就被邀请去向很多的大的生意人讲课。那当时呢，他就讲述了圣典《博迦瓦坛》。
So the Prabhupada picked a verse which describes that those people who are like hogs, dogs, camels, and asses will praise other people of a similar nature.
What is the last one? Camels and asses?
Asses, donkeys?
Got it. 那说爸爸说呢，就是那些喜欢猪、喜欢狗，还有喜欢骆驼和驴的这些人，那么他们在向别人在这个传播信息的时候呢，他们也会传播这些相应的信息。
So Prabhupada lectured about how modern society people are all like hogs, dogs, camels, and asses.
然后沙尔巴巴他就讲到，在这个就是当今的这个年代，人们都像是像猪啊、狗啊、驴啊，还有骆驼这样的状态。
So, Prabhupada described very in great detail about how people are very much on that, like animals in their activities. And the people were listening and they were laughing and they were enjoying Prabhupada's lecture.
然后当时释迦牟尼佛呢，他就非常细致地描述了，现代的这个人们如何都处在动物的这种状态下。当时在听这个课的这些人呢，就非常的，享受听释迦牟尼佛的这些讲述，
And so,
他们都在笑，回应着。
after Prabhupada's lecture, they all applauded. They said, "Very nice, Swamiji. You've spoken very nicely."
然后在说爸爸停止讲课之后呢，他们大家都为说爸爸鼓掌，就说 "Swamiji，您这课讲得太棒了。
And so, after the program, Prabhupada was talking to the devotees, and he said, "You see," he said, "I called them all hogs, dogs, camels, and asses, and they have applauded me, and they have praised me that I've spoken very nicely."
然后呢，在这课后呢，舍利巴巴就对奉献者说：“你看，我称呼这些人为猪、为狗、为骆驼，还有为驴子，但是呢，他们还特别喜欢听我讲话，他们还这个为我鼓掌，说我这讲得特别好哦。”
He said, "This is preaching." He said, "You have to be able to preach in such a way that you make it palatable, make it acceptable to people."
所以说，爸爸说这就是传教，就是你在传教的这个方式呢，必须得是让别人听起来舒服，让别人接受的一种方式来传教。
So that is austerity of speaking.
所以这就是言语的苦行。
Then there is austerity of the mind. Austerity of the mind is that we should be satisfied in whatever situation we are in.
另外一个呢，就是心意的苦行。心意的苦行就是我们时刻都要为我们所处在的这个状态而感到心满意足。
Just like at the present time, you know, there's often lockdown and so many restrictions are there. We have to tolerate these difficulties and shouldn't get disturbed.
那就比如说现在我们所处在这个状态哈，就还是有很多地方有很多的这个禁足啊，还有这个有很多的这个设限，所以呢，我们就必须要容忍我们现在所处在的所有的这些艰难的状态。
And then there's austerity of the body. Austerity of the body involves offering respect to seniors, like our spiritual master and our parents and our teachers and so on.
然后呢，就是我们身体的苦行。这身体的苦行呢，也就是要向别人致敬，就比如说像我们的灵性导师啊，还有像我们的这个长辈啊，向家长啊，向老师啊致敬。
So this is all austerity in goodness, and austerity in goodness will purify us and help us to progress, make it easier for us to transcend material nature.
这些都是在善良形态下的苦行。那么，在善良形态的苦行呢，它是非常的净化的，它是能够让我们超越的，超越到这个纯粹的状态中的。
Sugita Sangamati-ji, is it clear now?
Sugita Sangamati-ji, Guru Wen, 现在您对这个清楚了吗？Marge, while we are waiting for her answer, do you want to see the next question?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, 下面一个问题呢，是来自于 Gati Prada Mataji 的，顶拜 Guru Dev 和所有的奉献者们。同家里的帕布一起修行有2年多的时间了，帕布信心不是很强，念诵16圈时经常玩手机，还没有完全素食。请问 Guru，我要怎么更好的服务他，能帮助到他信心坚定的修行呢？Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances to you and to all the devotees. I already practice Krishna consciousness with my husband for more than 2 years. However, my Prabhu's faith is not very strong. And while he is chanting 16 rounds, he always play browsing his cell phone. And he is not 100% to take vegetarian meal. So my question to you is that what do I do to serve him better, in that case to help him to strengthen his faith to this practice?
Well, you have to try to cook more attractive meals that he wants to eat your food rather than eat other food.
您呢就要更好的做更好的 prasadam 的这个餐食, 使得您的丈夫能够更吸引的食用您所做的这个餐食, 而不是去吃其他人做的饭。
And you have to also encourage him to take more association with devotees.
而且呢，你也得鼓励他更多的和奉献者联谊。But
you're lucky. Many other devotees, they don't have such a nice husband who's trying to become a devotee.
但是呢，您非常的幸运，因为很多其他的奉献者都没有办法得到一个努力着想让自己成为奉献者的丈夫。
Many husbands are against the wife's practicing. They don't want to. They don't allow the wives to chant at home.
而且其实有很多的丈夫，他们其实是反对自己的妻子在家里边这个休息的，根本就不让他们的妻子在家里面念诵。So
you have a good husband. At least he has some hope. There's some hope that he can become a devotee.
那所以说呢，您有一个非常好的奉献者丈夫，至少呢，他很有希望能够成为主的很好的奉献者。 So the next one, and also Sukhita Sangamaji said that, thank you very much for your very patient answer. I am very clear now. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Sukhita Sangamaji 说这个谢谢姑的耐心的解答. So the next question from Yuna.
Yeah.
Lord Chaitanya's companions were great devotees, but they were incarnations of demigods, gopis, etc. How can we attain such pure devotion if we are not incarnations of great personalities? 原来的问题是，主产坦尼亚的同友们都是伟大的奉献者，但是呢，他们都是半神人啊、gopi啊等等的化身。那我们如何能够达到这样的纯粹的奉爱呢？ 因为我们要是并不是这些伟大人物的化身的话。Well,
everyone can become Nitya Siddha. You can also become Nitya Siddha. The more you absorb yourself in the chanting of the holy name and the process of Lord Chaitanya.
其实每一个人都可以成为 Nitya Siddha 永恒解脱的灵魂的，就是我们也可以成为，如果我们要是更深的沉醉在 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的冥想，以及更深的沉醉在对 Sri Krishna的圣名的念诵中的话。
Srila Prabhupada is encouraging all the devotees in ISKCON that they should also do like all of these associates of Lord Chaitanya. They should chant the holy name and they should be in ecstasy, they should be absorbed in service to Krishna.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri La Prabhupada, 他就鼓励我们所有人都应该像 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这些奉献者们那样去生活，就是我们要让自己很沉浸在对主的圣名的念诵之中，以及很沉浸的和奉献者联谊，这个为主做服务的这些活动之中。
Some of the associates of Lord Chaitanya were gopis, or some of them had maybe came from higher planets, but there were also others who were just beginning, taking up the process.
那主产丹尼玛巴布的有些同游是狗皮的化身，或者是来自于更高等星宿的半身人的化身，但是还有一些奉献者，他们只不过是一些初期者而已，是才刚刚开始起步。
Just like somebody becomes a millionaire, he makes a lot of money, big money. So somebody's born with a lot of money, and somebody else makes a lot of money in their lifetime. They're both rich men. We don't make a distinction.
就比如说哈，就是都是百万富翁，但是这百万富翁呢，有的人呢，他是一出生他就有好多钱，他就继承了很多钱。 那还有一些人，他成为百万富翁呢，是他在这一生中自己拼过自己的努力赚了很多钱，所以他们俩都是有钱人，所以我们不会做出一个他们是怎么有钱的区分。
So some people are just beginning devotional service, they're taking up pure they're coming to the level of pure devotion, and others are coming from other places.
所以有些人呢，他就是才刚刚开始他的奉赖，然后呢，让自己走在成为纯粹奉献者的这个路途之上，而有些人呢，他们就是从其他地儿来的。
In Rasa Lila, Krishna's Rasa Lila, there are gopis from all different levels. Some of the gopis were just coming up and they were just new into the pastimes of Krishna, and others were coming from the spiritual world.
那比如说在Sri Krishna的Rasa之舞的这个舞场上和Sri Krishna一起跳舞的这些gopi们，其实他们是来自于不同的这个层级的。那有些人呢，就是有些gopi呢是新，sorry，some of them is new from what? Some of them from the spiritual world, some of them from there.
From the material world. They're just coming up. They're new.
Okay, 那有些gopi们呢，他们其实是就是通过修习，刚刚从物质世界回到灵性世界的，就是刚刚升上来的。还有一些gopi们呢，他们就是直接来自于灵性世界的。So
they don't make distinction.
但是呢，我们不会去对他们进行区分。
We don't say, "Oh, you're a new devotee," or "You're not called." No, everyone's a devotee.
哎，我们不能说哦，你是一位新奉献者。
We don't know the past lives of different devotees.
而且呢，我们也不会去这个评判，这个不同的奉献者他的过往的生世是什么样的。
We've had many births in many different levels. Sometimes we've been demigods. Sometimes we've been beasts.
所以呢，我们其实是有很多的生世的，而且我们也是处在很多的这个层级之中的。有的时候我们可能是半圣人，有的时候可能就是野兽。Now
we have the opportunity to take up devotional service.
但是无论如何，我们现在就有这个机会来开始我们的奉献服务。Just
take the advantage and fully absorb yourself in Krishna's service.
那所以说我们要做的事情呢，就是完全的利用好这个机会，让自己完全的沉浸在对Sri Krishna的服务之中。
Okay, another question?
Yes, the next question from Panchatattva Prabhu. Dingbai Maharaj, 翻译主持人和所有的 Vaishnava 奉献者, Dingbai Prabhu. Ramananda Roy 和 Bhakti Vinodha Kaur 都是行政官员, 他们都是纯粹的奉献者, 奉献者如何才能找到这样的人? Maharaj, please accept my very humble obeisances and to all the devotees. Both Ramananda Roy and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur are the government officials, and both of them are pure devotees. So how can we actually find these devotees now? Because to preach to the materialist-oriented government officials are very dangerous.
Yes. Well, you have to understand that this was taking place in India, where the Vedic culture was prominent.
那我们必须要明白啊，就这个事情呢，是发生在印度的，因为印度的这个伟达文化是盛行的文化。
You know, when you're in India, then the majority of the people, they have that culture, they have that respect for the Vedic teachings.
那所以说呢，但你在印度的时候呢，就是因为他们是有这样的文化的，而且大部分的人们他们是尊重这样的教导的。And
it's not so easy in other places.
所以说呢，在其他的地方就没有那么容易。
So we have to be very conscious. The main program is to distribute literature, and by distributing books, then we hope that the books will find interested people, and the interested people will contact us for more information.
那所以呢，我们要小心。那我们最主要的活动呢，就是要派发一些文献、派发书籍。那我们希望在这个派发书籍的这个过程中呢，就是有一些人能拿到了这个书籍之后呢，他会对这个书籍感兴趣，然后他们会主动来找我们。
Right, we, that's, generally that's the procedure all over the world, that we will distribute books, and interested people, they get a book and then they contact us.
那这个其实是在世界广泛所采取的一种方式，就是我们会派发书，然后在这个书上呢会有这个联系方式，然后呢他们这个对这个书里的内容感兴趣的时候呢，他们就会来跟我们联系。
Somebody doesn't like the book, or they object to the book. Okay, really? I don't know. You know, just say you don't know anything.
但是You mean if they don't like this book and they reject it, and
just pretend that we, oh, just say, I don't know anything about the book, I just thought you might want to read it, I don't know.
Okay.
So you have to be cautious about these kind of things, about giving books to people. You have to be a little cautious of, you know, you have to think who might be interested to read this book.
而且呢，就是当我们在派书的时候，我们也要稍微的小心一点。我们需要有自己的一个判断，能看一下到底谁有可能会对这样的书感兴趣。
And sometimes we just leave the books laying around. We just leave the book, put the book somewhere where people pass by. And then if somebody's interested and they see the book, then they'll pick it up. Sometimes we put books into the libraries and let the libraries have the books.
有的时候呢，我们还会把书放到图书馆里面，让图书馆里面有机会大家去看到这个书。
And sometimes we put an advertisement, and you know, they're offer, and we offer, you know, that if you would like to have this book, you just contact me, and we'll send you a copy, and we can send, you know, a free copy to people, interested people.
但是有的时候呢，我们也会给人发这样一个信息，就是说。那我们有这样的书，如果您要是对这个书要是感兴趣的话呢，您就跟我联系，然后呢，我就会给您，送几本书。我们会有一些这个免费的书送给别人。
We have to always be thinking how to distribute this knowledge, how to give it to other people.
所以我们要时刻想着怎么来派发这个。
And Krishna from the heart, he will give us some inspiration how we can do it. But of course, you know, you have to be patient that some these things take time, and sometimes, you know, it's going to take quite long time. The books are there.But the books are out, and gradually people, and in the course of time, people will read the book.
但是呢，我们必须要有耐心，因为我们知道，就是要想得到这个结果的话，有的时候呢是需要花很长一段时间的。那么这个书反正是已经派出去了，所以呢，在就是人们要对这个书感兴趣，要有一些反应，还是需要等待一段时间的，所以我们要有耐心。
Just like sometimes they put bombs under the ground and they don't go off for a long time. And so books are like that, a bit like a time bomb. Okay.
Yes, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, good day.
Yeah.
现在已经一点半了，就是我们这个已经两个半小时了。
Okay.
所以说，我们还剩一个问题，我们下一节课再来回答好吗？
好。今天下午。
对，今天下午。
今天下午也是 Dana Kilifani 还是 Guru Mani？
Guru Mani。
所以那个问题你 你自己拿
我存下来。
好，
对对对，我保存下来。
OK OK， so 我们感谢那个 Danakili Mataji 给我们整台的翻译，我们感谢 Sati Jujur， 感谢所有的奉献者聆听提问，祝福你们节日快乐，祝福 Prabhupada Ki Jai
Jai
Jai， 谢谢 Maharaj，
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna， 好，那我